Hey everybody, and welcome to another video. As always, of course, don't forget to like and subscribe. You'd be helping me out a lot. So yeah, let's jump straight into it. In this video, I'm going to talk about moving the Songbird tokens and the experimental finance tokens that we've received, moving them to Bifrost wallet, how to get onto Flare Finance, and how to start, say, putting them into liquidity pools. Now, I don't know if you are like me. I had my tokens on Nexo during the snapshot. I know a lot of people have been complaining about Nexo. If most of my followers would know, I am a big fan of them for a lot of reasons. One of them is, like, so far they may have been a little bit late with some things, but they've always done exactly what they promised. So happy out. Anyway, I'm not here to promote Nexo. They don't pay me for any of that kind of stuff. But what I am here to do is just take you through my experience. Now, yesterday evening, I got this email. Your Songbird and ExFi are here. Thanks for participating in the airdrop. So you can see here. Dear Martin, Nexo has completed the distribution of the SGB and ExFi tokens to all eligible accounts. Check your ERC20 address because your assets have arrived. Now, that is exactly what I did. And we'll jump over to my wallet in a second and I'll show you. Anyway. Just to continue, just to finish it all here. Thank you for being an XRP holder on Nexo and for taking advantage of our services for the asset. We appreciate your active participation in the Songbird and experimental finance airdrops. And we're looking for future interactions. Now, once again, I have to say I'm very happy with them. I know people always say, not your keys, not your crypto. You shouldn't be holding anything on exchanges. However, I beg to differ. Which I'll go over in a different video. For now, just know, okay, Nexo sent me the tokens yesterday, I received them. Cool. So, people who've been following me for a bit longer know this plan. An update will be coming out soon because I've added a lot of other cool stuff to it. But this is the old one. If you haven't seen it yet, please do check it out. It's called My Plan 2.0. I'll link it down below. In short, this section here is about Nexo. This section here is about, like, just property. Here is the XRP ledger. Here we have kind of Flare networks with Songbird network with XFi on top of it. And then here we'll have the Flare finance on top of Flare networks in this side as well, right? So I've kind of mapped out my whole plan. Now, as I said, an update is coming. But do check this out just to get an idea of what I'm talking about. Now, another kind of thing that I want to say is before you continue this video, if you do not understand what an automated market maker is and how it works, and if you do not understand impermanent loss, please check that out first, because there are always risks involved, and I explain it in two videos I did earlier. This one here, automated market makers explained, and this one here, impermanent loss explained. So the order I would advise you to look at these is, first look at this one, automated market makers, just to get an idea of how the price actually comes to exist, and then also look at impermanent loss. And I want you to do this just that you understand the risks that are involved. Now, I'm just going to get ahead of questions that I always get. When you're in a liquidity pool, you can put, like, two different types of assets together, right? If you do it with USD, right, US dollar or whatever, like, stable-ish kind of asset, right? I'm just going to call it that for now. The volatility is always less than when you put it, say, against another volatile crypto asset, right? When you put two in together. But please watch these videos; they explain all of it. I'm doing this because I want to educate you, and I want you to not make mistakes and not lose money. Now, once you've done that, please continue. Come back here and continue this video. Now, that being said, as I kind of explained here in this plan, the whole Flare Finance part, like, it's now slowly starting to come into play. If you still have no idea what I'm talking about, I'll also link this white paper. This is the white paper from Flare Finance. I'll link it down below. It's a bit older now, like, it's been out for a while. But if you just have a quick read, they do explain, like, a lot of stuff, right? The how Flare X works, liquidity pools. And they give kind of a breakdown of it. Now, if this is too complicated and you don't understand it, just check it out anyway and read it, and just let me know, and then I can go into a bit more depth about it later on. But they do explain the basics of Flare Finance. Okay, now moving on again. let's get busy, like let's get working. So a couple of things, I've also hooked up my phone to my screen so you can follow along what I do on my phone. And I've got my MetaMask set up. Now, obviously here from Nexo, I got my tokens, I got them in my MetaMask. So the very first thing you can see here is that I'm on the Songbird network. And then here I've received my Songbird tokens and my ExFi tokens. Now I will be blurring out the amounts here in the start of this video. And I'm only going to transfer over a portion so that we then I can I won't have to blur out like the rest once it's left Songbird, or once it's left MetaMask. And what we will be doing is we will be sending it to Bifrost, which I have here, which you can also see right now once I've logged in, has 3 tokens in it right now: Songbird, Wrapped Songbird, and Experimental Finance. Now you can see there's hardly any Songbird in there. What is it, 75 cents worth. Wrapped Songbird and Experimental Finance is both on zero. Now, the reason they are both on zero is because I've been playing around with a little bit with Flare Finance just to see how it works before I recorded this video. But obviously now we're gonna go through the whole process again. Now, so let's get started basically, right? So the very first thing that I'm going to need is I'm going to have to send it to, that's a better background. And then here we have my phone. I want to send my, let's start off with the Songbird tokens. So here at the bottom, you have a bunch of buttons. We'll be using a few of them. The very first thing that we're gonna do is click on this up arrow here, like that, and then click on receive. There we go. And then here you have like a list of tokens to receive. Now, obviously we want Songbird, so I'm gonna click up here on Songbird. If it's not at the top, you can type it in up here. I'll show you SGB. There you go, it pops up. But you can also just click straight away if it's already there, right? Songbird. Now, here we have the address. So obviously you can tap to copy that address, right? You can see I've done that right now. Obviously I've posted it elsewhere on my computer because I'm gonna use MetaMask on my computer. Just to show you. Okay, so I've got that copied. Once that's copied, we go to MetaMask. We're gonna send Songbird, right? So I'm just gonna click on that. Here, I'm gonna click on send. And I'm gonna send it to that address that I just copied. Now, let me just get it over here. That is this one. Now, you can see, once I filled it in, you see asset and amount. Now, asset, there's a down arrow here, right? So you can click on that and you can switch between either the Songbird or ExFi token. Now, let's start off with Songbird. There we go. And I'm going to transfer over, what will I say for now? Put in 100 Songbird. All right. Here you can see the gas price, and I'm gonna click on next. So we're sending 100 Songbird, and here you can see the maximum fee is gonna be 0.004725. Here you can see the total amount, and I'm gonna click on confirm. Now you can see it's pending right now. Okay, well that's busy, I'm just gonna leave that be. I'm gonna go back to assets. I'm now gonna click on ExFi. Now, sometimes ExFi pops up as zero. If I'm just gonna hover over this here, you can see they have trouble loading the amount, but as you also just saw, it just popped up now, right? So just ignore that, it's fine. But I'm gonna click on ExFi, gonna click on send, gonna put in the same address. Here you can see ExFi tokens, how much you wanna transfer over. Now, let's say, 10 ExFi tokens, and click on next. Here, once again, you can see the 10 tokens and the fees. I'm gonna click confirm. Okay, and that's pending. Okay, you can see the Songbird tokens have been sent and the ExFi is still pending. Let me click that away, grab the phone again. Let's have a look in the wallet. It's gonna refresh. Okay, so you can see I have indeed received my Songbird tokens and I've received the ExFi tokens. What we're gonna do next is we're just going to have a look first before I actually do it, on Flare Finance. Now, I'm just going to get an address here. Give me 2 seconds. Okay, done. So what we're going to do now is these four squares that you see at the bottom, we're going to click on that. Now you can see, you can type a URL in here, and here you have saved bookmarks. Now for me at the moment, I've deleted them on purpose just to go through the process. There's no bookmarks here. However, here in the top, we can fill in a URL. And that is what I'm going to do right now. Just give me 2 seconds. I'm just going to click away my phone because I need to go and grab it here. Okay, there we go. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to type an address in here, which you can see the right there. So that is https :/xff.flr.finance/. Now I will be putting all this information down below in the description, so you can check it out all down below. But once I fill that in here in the top, I'm going to hit click down here on search. Now you can see that it's loading the Flare Finance like website within the within Bifrost, and here we can select the networks, right? So Songbird or Ethereum. Now I'm just going to leave it on Songbird for now. I'm going to click here on connect. Now once that's done, we're now connected to Flare Finance, right? Now the next thing that we want to do, or actually the first thing, is click on these three dots up here, and then add bookmark. Add bookmark. Perfect. So now I'm going to exit out of it by hitting this X just to show you. It's now been added to the bookmarks, right? So even if I go completely out of this, I'm just going to click X on here to get rid of the address. I'm going to just go to the wallet down here. And I'll say the next time I want to go into Flare Finance, I just click on these four squares. It's here as a bookmark. So I just click on that and we go straight in, right? Songbird Network, perfect. Click connect. Right, that's just how to get in and out of it. Now, at the top here, you see two tabs, All Pools and My Portfolio. As I said before, I just put a few tokens in just to test it. So if I click on My Portfolio right now, you should only see two things. You can see here, I'm staking very little XFi and I'm earning SFIN at the moment. Here you can see what I staked. What is it, 1.5? If I go down a little bit here, you can see some Wrapped Songbird is earning SFIN as well. Here you can see I staked 614 Wrapped Songbird, right? Now, and other than that, there's nothing down here because these are the only two things that I kind of just tested with before. Now, if I go back to All Pools, click on that, you can see all of the possibilities, right? So we've got the Wrapped Songbird here for SFIN. We've got the X5 for SFIN. Here we've got SFIN for XFIN. We've got CANS for SFIN, SGB. Now, and this is where why I want you to check out the other two videos, right? So the automated market makers one and the impermanent loss one, because this is the part that I need you to understand before throwing your money at it. Is here you can see these are kind of single assets, right? See that? If we go down below, here you can see the pairs are starting to come in, right? Now, usually the rewards will be bigger with the pairs. They're also more risky, and that's because of the impermanent loss. Now, impermanent loss is something that you have to understand before you even touch this platform, okay? And it's not that hard to understand, and I know I'm plugging my own videos here, but please do watch it, right? It will save you a lot of money and complaining afterwards. Just watch it. Now, I'm not gonna mention it again this time, or I'll try not to anyway. I'm just gonna assume that you've now by this time watched it. But you can see all the other pairs here as well. Okay, so cool. So how do we actually get it in there? Now, first things first, I'm going to go back to my wallet. So I've got Songbird, and I've got no Wrapped Songbird. But if you saw it here at the... It's going to go back into Flare Finance again. We need Wrapped Songbird, right? So the very first step, and maybe some of you know this, but I'm just going to walk through it anyway. Is we need to wrap it first. So what do we do? Back to the wallet. Here I'm going to click on Songbird. Then here on these three dots, Here we've got wrap. And then how much? Now, we just sent over a 100, so let's wrap all 100. Click, type it in, click on continue. Here we can see, okay, I've now wrapped it. Here you can see the fee, and I'm gonna click on confirm. Now, type in my PIN, obviously blurring that out. There we go, done. If I now go back, we can now see that I have now wrapped Songbird here. Okay, cool. So now that we've got wrapped Songbird and we've got ExFi, let's go and put them to work. So we're going back into Flare Finance. Click on Flare Farm. Obviously, Flare Farm is only one of the products that they'll be offering, but for now, this is the only one that we're using. Flare Farm. Yep, connect to Songbird network. That's fine. So let's put that 100 wrapped Songbird to work. It's very easy. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to, we can claim it, we can change staking and exit. So we're going to change the staking. So click on that. I'm going to pull the slider all the way over to the 100% because you can see that 100 is available here. So I want to add them all in. There we go. Stake 100. And here I'm going to click on stake. Done. Confirm. Type in the PIN code. Close. There we go. Pending transaction. You can see it's thinking here. I'm going to take a sip while it's working. Okay, that's now done. We can now see that the amount has been changed. I am now staking 700, like that 100 has been added to the wrapped Songbird that I already had there previously. Great, so that's done. Same goes for the ExFi. So ExFi for SFIN, change staking. You can see there's 10 available. Also, I didn't show you this in the previous one, but it works the same. If I were to click on unstake, you can see what's available right now, right? It's here as well. But I don't want to unstake, I want to add. So I'm gonna click on stake. Once again, I'm gonna add everything. So I'm just gonna pull it across. There you go, the 10, stake ExFi. There we go, the fees and all that kind of stuff. Confirm. Type in the passcode again. And close. Yeah, once again, it's pending. So this should pop up again in a few seconds. There we go. That's done. Yeah, maybe we can see now the new amount. So the 10 has been added. If you want to play around, actually, let me just point this out as well, right? So the whole point of this right now, right? So we've wrapped our Songbird and we're earning SFIN. Here, we've got our ExFi and we're earning SFIN. The next step will be, once you've earned SFIN, to put ExFin in, and then you'll have the SFIN earning SFIN, right? So these are all, like it's a big wheel that's just turning and getting more and more and more, which I'll explain here in this process. And I know this picture might look a bit overwhelming and it zoomed out a bit. Once again, don't forget there's an updated version coming, but what we're doing is we're creating these loops, these feedback loops, and it's like this snowball effect of just getting more and more and more money, right? And money that you get working for others. Now that's it. Now I think for now, what I wanted to show you today. If I go back to my wallet, you'll also see here, my wrapped Songbird now is gone down to zero. My ExFi has gone down to zero because it's no longer here, right? It's in Flare Finance. So just know that it's there. And that's why this has gone down. That's all I wanted to talk about today. Please, if you got anything from this video that you found useful, do me a favor, please like the video, subscribe, obviously. They'll stay up to date with all my future explanations. And that's it for now. All right, guys, thank you very much.